Hello everyone, welcome to W3 Grad's Quick Tech Solutions. In this video we will look in what is throw and throws keyword in Java. We will also understand the difference between them along with the situations in which they are used. First, let us begin with understanding what is throw keyword is in Java. The Java throw keyword is used to explicitly throw an exception. We can throw either checked or unchecked exception in Java by throw keyword. The throw keyword is mainly used to throw custom exception. We can use the same method to throw custom errors as well in our program. Let us see how throw works in Java with the help of a live example. We already have our Eclipse IDE open. We will right click on our package W3 Grads Tutorial, then select New, and then select Class. After that, we will name the class as Thrower and Throws Demo, and then we will check the public static void main method option, and finally, we will click on Finish. A new class named Thrower and Throws Demo will be created with automatically created main method in it. We will notice some auto-generated comment as well. So, we will get rid of that. Here, in this example, we will create a divide method that takes two integer variables as parameters. If the value of second parameter is 0, it will throw an arithmetic exception, otherwise, it will return the division of first number by second number. Now just below our public class we will type public static double divide along with parentheses. Now, inside the parentheses, we will type double a comma double b. After that, we will put two curly braces, and inside these curly braces, we will use if-else statement. So, we will type if followed by parentheses. Now, within these parentheses, we will specify a condition that is, b equal to 0. Then, we will again put two curly braces, and inside the curly braces, we will type throw new arithmetic exception, parentheses, and pass a string, invalid division, as an argument. After that, just outside the if block, we will write else along with two curly braces. Now, within the curly braces, we will type return a forward slash b. So, we are now done with our method, and it is time for us to call it inside the main method. Therefore, we will go inside the main method, and type system.out.println, and call divide method inside its parentheses. We will deliberately pass arguments as 10, 0. On saving the code, and executing it, we will see a runtime exception stating, exception in thread, main. java.lang.arithmetic-colon-invalid-division@w3gradstutorial.thrower-and-throws-demo.divide-bracket-thrower-and-throws-demo.java:6 at w3gradstutorial.thrower-and-throws-demo.main-bracket-thrower-and-throws-demo.java:13. Here, 6 and 13 are the line numbers which caused exception. So, this is how throw keyword works. Now let's take a look at the throws keyword. The Java throws keyword is used to declare an exception, or a list of exceptions that may occur during the method execution. It provides information to the programmer about the occurrence of an exception and the type of exception, so that the programmer can handle it by implementing the exception handling mechanism. Thus, the programmer can ensure that the normal flow of program can be maintained. So, let us understand the working of throws keyword as well with the help of a quick example. So, we will again go to the Eclipse IDE, where we have already created a method that throws an arithmetic exception at runtime. We will go to the same divide method, and just before the opening curly brace, we will type throws keyword followed by arithmetic exception. By doing this, we have indicated to the programmers that this method will throw an arithmetic exception when invoked. So, the programmers need to handle this exception using the exception handling mechanism. Therefore, we will handle this exception. We will go inside our main method, and we will surround the print line statement with try block. For that, we will type try followed by a pair of curly braces. Then we will select the entire print line statement, and cut it, then paste it inside the curly braces after the try keyword. Just after the try block, we will type catch with parentheses, and pass an arithmetic exception object A inside those parentheses. Then, we will add two curly braces, and inside these curly braces, we will print the custom string thrown by the arithmetic exception constructor inside the divide method. So, we will type system.out.println, and pass a.getMessage as an argument. On executing the code, we will see the output as invalid division. So, this shows the working of throws keyword. Now that we have understood the working on thrower and throws keyword, let us do a comparative study of both these keywords. The following table shows the difference between thrower and throws keywords. The first point says, throw keyword is used to throw an exception explicitly. Whereas, the throws keyword is used to declare one or more exceptions, separated by commas. We have already seen that through examples that if we want a method to deliberately throw an exception, we can do that by using a throw keyword with the object of particular exception. However, we can indicate to the programmers that executing the method has the possibility to throw one or more exceptions, so the programmer need to take care of it. The next point says, only single exception is thrown by using throw. However, multiple exceptions can be thrown by using throws. Obviously, throw keyword can be used to throw one exception at a time, while you can indicate one or more exceptions separated by commas using the throws keyword. The third point says, throw keyword is used within the method, while throws keyword is used with the method signature. This we have already seen in our examples. The fourth point says, throw is followed by an instance of exception class while throws is followed by exception class name. We can understand this through our divide method. Here, throw keyword was followed by new arithmetic exception, which is nothing but the instance of arithmetic exception class. However, when throws keyword was used, it was followed by directly the arithmetic exception, which is the class name. The second last point says, a checked exception is propagated to the caller method, while unchecked exceptions are not propagated, thus may not require explicit exception handling. The last point says, using throw keyword we can also break a switch statement or a loop without using break keyword, which cannot be performed using throws. Well, this brings to the end of the video. I hope you have enjoyed this video and understood the concept well. So, keep learning and I will see you next time. Until then, please don't forget to subscribe our channel and press the bell icon for more interesting videos. Thank you.